Around 5 to 7 million years back, modern human ancestors are believed to have evolved in Africa, particularly in the modern-day countries like Ethiopia, Kenya, and Tanzania. Then slowly, these humans migrated to parts of Africa, Europe, and Asia, and settled there. But here is a question. While it's obvious that they traveled to parts of Asia and Europe via land, how did these humans come to modern-day North and South America? If you look into this map, you can see it's not easy, because there is a huge Atlantic Ocean that restricts humans from crossing easily. So, how did these humans come to the Americas? You might say, by boat, but let me remind you, at that time, there were no boats capable of traveling from Africa to the Americas. It's very recently that the boat that can travel this long distance was invented, and also back then, there was no means of flying as well. So, how did the first human come to the Americas? No matter how developed the Americas is today, whether that be in terms of trade, scientific discoveries, and economy, it was the last continent that human colonized. Yes, humans came to America very late. Historians believe that modern-day humans came to the Americas at around 18,000 to 26,000 years ago. That is almost after 280,000 years after the first human evolved in Africa. This is backed by the evidence of the first human footprint found in New Mexico, which is believed to be dated 23,000 years old. But one question still remains the same. How did they travel from Africa to the American continents despite the huge ocean barrier? Did they travel through the water? And if they did, is it even humanly possible without any modern equipment? Well, historians have proposed several theories on that matter. Let's start with the most widely believed theory, Bering Land Bridge Theory. Bering Land Bridge Theory, or also called Beringia, supports the idea that the first humans migrated to America from Asia, not crossing this huge Atlantic Ocean from Africa. This theory posits that, during the last ice age, specifically at various periods when sea levels were significantly lower, an expanse of land connected the northeastern corner of Asia of modern-day Siberia to the northwestern corner of North America, which is Alaska today. This land bridge formed, known as Beringia, provided a route for people, animals, and plants to cross between the two continents, and historians believe that the migrants came to the American continent following herds of large animals such as mammoths, which were their source of food, clothing, and tools. The Bering Land Bridge Theory is supported by various types of evidence. Archaeological findings in both Siberia and Alaska show similarities in tools and hunting techniques. Also, genetic studies have revealed links between Native American populations and populations in northeastern Asia. Over time, as the climate warmed and the ice melted, sea levels rose again, submerging Beringia beneath the waters of the Bering Strait and isolating the Americas from Asia, which led to the development of distinct cultures and populations in the New World. This is just one of the many theories scientists believe and have strong evidences for. But there are other theories as well, which highlights the other means the early humans could have come to America. Atlantic Theory. Instead of crossing a land bridge from Siberia to Alaska, Atlantic theory suggests that the early humans traveled from Europe to North America across the North Atlantic. This migration could have occurred by following the edge of the ice sheet that extended from the Arctic down across the North Atlantic, or by navigating open waters with primitive boats. This theory is not very widely accepted among the scholars, but this came into the limelight due to archaeological findings, such as similarities between stone tools of European Solutrean culture and the Clovis points found in early American archaeological sites, suggesting a transatlantic link. But the main criticisms of this theory are the lack of direct evidences for such early transatlantic navigation. And genetic studies also strongly support Asian ancestry for Native American populations rather than European ancestry. And there is also another popular theory that suggests that the early human could have come to America from the Oceania region. Oceania theory. Oceania theory, also known as the Pacific Coastal Migration Model, is another hypothesis regarding the peopling of the Americas. This theory proposes that the first humans arrived in the Americas, not by crossing the Bering Land Bridge, but rather by following a coastal route from Asia across the Pacific Ocean. The theory suggests that these early migrants used boats to island hop or follow the coastline southward from Northeast Asia, navigating along the edges of the Pacific Rim, until they reached the Americas. Oceania theory suggests that instead instead of early humans moving to South America from North America, they might have come to the west coast of South America first and started moving upwards to North America. This theory came into the limelight when the researchers found genetic link between the indigenous populations in the Americas and peoples from coastal Asia and Oceania. And this theory became more popular when a Norwegian explorer, Thor Heyerdahl, went for Kon-Tiki expedition across the Pacific Oceans by using raft in 1947. This expedition shows that it was possible for ancient Polynesians to travel by raft from South America to Polynesia. These are three of many ancient pathways on how our ancestors could have come to America. No matter what, this shows that history of human migration to the Americas is complex as it can be. These narratives of migration not only deepen our understanding of human history, but also remind us of the diverse and complex journeys that have shaped the development of cultures across the Americas. But which theory out of these you think is most convincing? Write down in the comment section down below. Also, make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more educational content.